I don't know if you knew about this, but you can actually customize the context menu in Windows, or the right-click menu as it's more commonly referred to. You can add custom items to it and change the way that it looks, and it's actually quite easy too. Now, you probably already know this, but the context menu in Windows 11 isn't exactly user-friendly, and it's one of the many things people hate about the stock Windows 11 experience. I mean, as you can see here, Microsoft replaced some of these options with icons, and to get access to the old context menu, you need to click on the Show More Options button here, and that just annoys me. But that's why we have Shell, a powerful, highly customizable, free and open source context menu manager for Windows. The best part is that it works on older versions of Windows too, so if you're still using Windows 10, you can use Shell to create your own custom context menu too, and that's exactly what I'm going to be showing you in this video. So let's start by downloading and installing Shell. So to do that, you can visit nilesoft.org in your browser of choice, and then just click on the download button here, and you'll be taken to the downloads page. Now, you'll have a few different options. You can either click on the download button here to download the installer, or you can use one of these package managers to install it. Now, I would suggest that you take a look at these commands, because this website seems to go down from time to time, so you won't be able to download the installer. In that case, you can run PowerShell as an administrator on your PC, and then just use one of these commands to install Shell. For example, you can execute this winget command, and that'll automatically download and install Shell to your computer. But if you choose to download the installer, like I'm doing here, you can just run it, go through the normal installation prompt, and then once it's finished, you'll have Shell installed with the default theme, which is what you see here. So right now, it doesn't look any good though, does it? I mean, you can see from the taskbar that I have dark mode enabled, but the context menu is still white for some reason. But don't worry, I'll show you how to fix that soon. For now, let's just see what's changed. So you'll probably notice that Show More Options is now gone, and I have access to all of the normal context menu functions, but there are a few other ones added too. For example, I have this terminal menu here where I can launch PowerShell or CMD. I have this File Manage menu with a few very handy shortcuts like copying an entire file path, showing file extensions and hidden files and folders and so on. Then finally, I have this Go To menu with a bunch of shortcuts to folders and settings in Windows. But my favorite here is the All Control Panel Item shortcut, which takes you directly to the All Tasks menu, where you have access to a whole bunch of very useful utilities and settings in Windows. Now, that's just a basic overview of what the standard installation of Shell does, but we can do so much more with it. For example, we can add or remove items from the context menu, we can change the theme and make it look real nice, and we can even add new functions, and this is all explained in depth by the developer over at nilesoft.org/docs, in case you want to have a look at that. So to edit the context menu, you can press and hold left shift on your keyboard and then right click on the taskbar. You should also see a shell option like I have here, and you'll see if I move the mouse cursor to it, I have access to all of these other options here. The one I'm interested in for now is this directory option here. So I'm going to click on that and it will open the folder where shell is installed and, more importantly, where the config files are located. Now, you can open and edit the config files with any text editor like Notepad or Notepad++, for example, but what I'm going to be using is Cursor, which is a free code editor, but you can use whatever program you want. The primary configuration file is this shell.nss file here, so I'm just going to open that with Cursor. Now you'll see these lines of code here, and what I want to show you is at the bottom here you have these import commands, which imports other config files into the main shell.nss config file. Those config files are located in the imports folder that you see here on the left in the shell directory. So let's say that I want to remove the terminal menu from the context menu, for example. In that case, I can just delete this line of code here, which imports the terminal configuration file. Now, after removing that entry, I'll just save the file by pressing Ctrl and S. And before you'll see the changes, you need to restart the Windows Explorer process. But a quick way to do this with Shell is to just press and hold down Ctrl on your keyboard and then right-click. It'll refresh the context menu, and now you'll see that the terminal menu is removed. It's no longer a part of the context menu. So you can go ahead and remove the other config files as well if you don't want access to those shortcuts, but you still want to use the themes that Shell provides. But we'll get to customizing the themes a little bit later on in the video. So like I mentioned earlier, we can also add our own entries to the context menu. As an example, let's add an entry that launches the browser and another one that launches the calculator. To do that, at the end of this file here, I'm going to add this command. I'll also include this command in my written guide on my website, and I'll have a link to that in the description of the video. So then you can just go ahead and copy and paste the command from there. But basically, this command just adds a new item to the context menu, and now we have to fill in these blanks. So I'm going to give it a title of browser because it's going to launch the browser. And now we need to tell this command where to fetch the image or icon that must be displayed on the context menu and what application it must launch. So to do that, I'm going to right-click on my browser icon here and then select properties. That's going to give me the full file path for the executable file that launches my browser. So now I can just copy that and then paste it into the image tag as well as the CMD or command tag. Now if I save the config file and then refresh the shell by holding down Control and right-clicking like I mentioned earlier, you'll notice that I now have this browser entry here. If I click on it, it launches a new instance of my browser. But what if I wanted it to open a new tab in the browser window that I currently have open? Well, in that case, you can add the following command at the end here, which will always launch it to the specific URL you have defined here. So in this example, I'll just add the Google URL and then save the file again. Now, if I use the browser shortcut in the context menu, it actually launches a new tab in the existing instance of the browser that's already open. And that takes me to the Google homepage because that's the URL that I have defined in the config file. So that's one example of something you can add to the context menu, but let me show you how to add a Windows app like the calculator, for example. You can use the same syntax as before, and for the sake of time, I'm just going to copy and paste this command here and then save the file. Now you'll see I have an entry that launches the calculator. But the issue I have is that the calculator image or icon isn't being displayed on the context menu because there's an issue with my image command here in the config file. So there are basically two ways that you can go about adding images. One method you can use is to go to the Shell website and then go to the Glyphs tab. Next, find your preferred image. I'm going to use this calculator one for example, and then just copy the code. Now go back to the config file and paste the code next to the image field. But you have to take note that the quotes must be removed when using this method. It should just be image, the equal symbol, and then the code, no quotes. If I save the file and refresh the context menu, I now have that calculator icon or glyph showing on the context menu that I got from the Shell website. Now for method 2, you can add a custom image. So in this example, I'm just going to do a Google search for the Windows calculator icon and then download the PNG file from Wikimedia. Now what I'll do is, I'll just navigate to the Shell installation folder and then just create a new folder here called Images and then save the image inside of that folder. Then once it's saved, I can just navigate to that image file, right-click on it, and then copy the entire file path. Now I can paste that file path into the image section in the config file and just make sure that it's in between quotes again and then save the file. Now if I go ahead and refresh the context menu, you'll see that it displays that image as the icon next to the calculator entry. So this is basically just touching the surface of what you can do with Shell, and you can even add your own menus with submenus and a whole bunch of items, and we're definitely not going to be getting into all of that in this video. What I want to show you next is how you can change the theme of the context menu. Now to change the theme, you have to open the theme configuration file, which is saved here in the imports folder. So like I said before, Shell is highly customizable and there are a lot of things you can change, but I just want to show you a few of the basics I use to make the context menu look nice. For starters, to change it from this white menu to a dark one, just make sure that this dark value is set to true. Now you'll see if I refresh the context menu, it looks so much better already, and you can basically just leave it like this if you're happy with the way it looks. But there are some more things we can do, and I want to show you that too. For example, we can define a custom color by using a hex code. So as an example, I'm just going to copy and paste this hex code, which is for the color blue. Now I'll also need to change the opacity value here, so I'm just going to change it to 90. If I save the file and refresh the context menu, you'll see it's blue. Now you can play around with the opacity. You can change the value to anything between 0 and 100. So if I change it to 30, for example, you'll see that it's a bit more transparent. But for now, I'm just going to change the color value back to default so it matches the system theme a little better. Now, Shell includes a few predefined effects, so let me show you those quickly. If I change the effect value to 1 and the opacity to 0 and then refresh the context menu, you'll see that it's completely transparent now. So effect 1 makes the context menu completely transparent, provided you have the opacity set to 0 as well, and this is what it will look like in that case. Now, if I change the effect value to 2 and still leave the opacity on 0 and then refresh the context menu, you'll see that it's added a blur effect. Personally, I like this a little bit more than the completely transparent menu because it makes the text on the menu a little bit more visible. But I know there are some of you who wants the menu to be completely transparent, and in that case you can use Effect Value 1. But some other things I want to show you are the following. At the top here, just below the dark entry, you can add a font size command. If I set this to 30, for example, you'll see that the context menu is now huge because the font has increased. If I set this to a very small value, like 5, for example, you'll see that the context menu is very small. Now, I don't usually use the font size setting, but another one you can use is the font name setting. If you set the font name to a font you have installed on your system, and I'll add that in between quotes, otherwise it won't work, you'll see that the font on the context menu has changed. So you can change the font if you want to with this command here, but I'm just going to remove this and then save the file, which will set it back to the default system font. Now the last setting I want to show you here is the view setting. If you change the view to compact, like I'm doing here, you'll see I have a much more compact context menu, and I know a lot of people will prefer to have it like this because it doesn't take up as much space on the screen. But if you don't want to use this setting, just remove it and then save the file. So this is basically what my shell theme config file looks like, and it makes the context menu look like this. Now at the time of this recording, this is what I like using, but who knows, it might change in the future. But once you're happy with your shell config and you like the way that it looks, what I recommend you do is you can either just make a backup of these config files that you changed and save them in your documents or another important file that you'll remember to backup before formatting your PC, or you can just make a backup of the entire shell folder to a directory that you'll remember to backup before you format your computer. In that case, you won't have to edit these files every time you do a clean install of Windows. You can just copy your config files back into the shell installation folder, and then you'll have your custom context menu again. Now, it's also worth mentioning that you can download pre-made theme config files and then just copy and paste them into your shell folder. And this GitHub user is one of those people who makes these themes. And you can also visit the shell forum where there are some pre-made theme files that you can download and use.
But with that being said, if you want to support this channel, you can check out my YouTube member section, or if you just want to be a part of my Discord community, you can find a link to that down below. Thanks so much for watching. I'll talk to you guys soon.